So, I've just spent almost 20 minutes talking into a microphone that wasn't plugged in. Yep. So we did an unboxing, and I unwrapped a new book. Good night, nurse. All right. So should I even read this again? Basically, this is a book about an FBI agent and a robot who have to investigate a terrorist activity. So there's that new book that we just got. I'm tired. That's part of it. So this new configuration here. I've added a third monitor, so everything has flipped because I've got the big TV monitor over here now, and I've got these two, so the tower has gone over this way and the soundboard has gone over here, and this microphone moves. So whenever we do Good Morning Multiverse, this microphone goes over to Mindy's desk, and it's a different microphone cable, and they share a port here because I've only got four microphone ports here, and so I forgot to switch it back. Yes, the sign is back. Yes, I decided with the TV moving over here, that gave us room. We put Ray's sign back up. I thought it would be a nice thing to have. You can see it back over there in the background with the LED lights. So, ha ha ha, yes, I've heard of a sound check. The thing is, it's a weird thing because I'm looking over here at the little bouncy LEDs, and it was going, and I don't know. Yes. Too many things to keep track of all at once, and I'm old and tired. So there we are. Anyway. So, to reiterate, I managed to get a review out of this book. It's a good book. It's a fun read. Characters are a little shallow. There are a lot of hand-of-the-writer moments. So, yes, it probably did give me the ping just kind of went... I heard it when I turned this thing up. Usually I hear things. And I had my sound up on, as I'm monitoring the chat, I had my sound up for the opening, and I heard that, and I guess I just turned it down a little bit too soon. So, anyway. One of these days, everything will work the way it's supposed to work, and I won't know what to do with myself. So, there we are. So Tuesday we have the shelter in place order taking effect. That'll be fun. Even though I'm usually here at home anyway, so it's not really much of a difference for me, but it's an adjustment for a lot of people to make. What are you doing down here? You're supposed to be... Oh, y'all are going to start this, are you? I don't have the dog camera set up yet. All right. Okay. Junior office dog made her presence known. She came in, circled around. What is she doing? Hang on a second here. I'll be right back. Okay. Junior office dog sometimes has a tendency to do things she's not supposed to. Because she's young yet. Anyway, alright, so apologies for the sound going bad. So anyway, what else? New Warriors. Oh, see, I went through all of this. I just went through all of this really great, brilliant stuff, and about Marvel's New Warriors and Children of the Atom stuff, and how terrible it was going to be, and nobody heard it. Story of my life, you know. That's just the way it is. The problem. And we talked about this with the show today on the comics industry. The publishers are just doing their thing. Marvel, especially, is just doing their thing and not paying attention to what anybody is telling them and not listening to the customers. And this bit with the new Warriors, you know, Safe Space and Snowflake, and then you got the Children of the Atom, and one of them's got a TikTok. I mean, these nobody's going to buy these books. Nobody is going to buy these books. The stores are not going to order the books. The customers are not going to want the books. Nobody is going to buy this stuff. It's dead on arrival. If they ship 1,500 copies, I'll be surprised. I don't know. Just one of those things. It just looks dumb. It really does look like a Saturday Night Live parody. That promo where they did Black Widow as a romantic comedy. You know, remember that spot? That's what this stuff feels like. It really feels like they sat there and said, "Hey, let's troll everybody. Let's just do these things as a gag." It can't be real. It's real, but it shouldn't be. It's just, I don't know. I haven't picked up a Marvel comic in a long time, so I'm not invested as a fan. But just from the standpoint of watching the comics industry implode, this is not going to help. And I have a feeling that coming out of this quarantine stuff, a lot of comic shops are going to be hurting, and Marvel's not going to make anything better by the stuff that they're doing. Their business practices, more than any other publisher in the industry, has done more harm to the comic book shops than any other publisher that I'm aware of. I'm still playing catch up on how all of this has shaken out in the last 10 years, but it's been a mess, and Marvel's been responsible for a good deal of it. With their constant events and number ones and reboots and new characters taking over for old legacy characters and all the variant covers and everything. It's, yeah. Marvel has done a lot to hurt the industry. So we'll see when we get on the back side of this quarantine stuff. I'm really hoping that enough comic shops have survived that the industry can sustain itself. Otherwise, yeah, who knows? I mean, the publishers will figure out a way to get comics out to the market. But if enough comic book shops go under because of all of this going on with the quarantine, direct market, the direct market may go away, and we may be looking at other different, you know, other ways of getting comics out to people, whether it's newsstand or Walmart or wherever. But the direct market with the comic book shops, they're hurting. So I don't know. It's a tough time all the way around. But for the comic book shops especially, they've been hit hard, and they've been hurting for years. So Richard Meyer was doing an analysis, looking at trends, and it's been a steady decline in sales since 2000, yeah. You know, over 20 years, sales of comic books have gone down. Historically, they've trended down. There've been some years that are better than others, and it'll do one of these, but it's doing one of these as it's going down. So I don't know. We'll see once we get on the other side of this quarantine what exactly happens. But the comic book shops need help. The publishers are not. Some of them are stepping up. Some of them are you know, delaying books and offering more returnability on books and stuff like that. But yeah, it's not going to do any good if the books aren't any good. Get good writers. Get good artists. Tell good stories. That's first and foremost what needs to happen. Don't give us this politically correct, social, you know, keyboard warrior Tumblr crap. Marvel, looking directly at you. We still have not heard anything from DC as far as the adjustments that are being made for the quarantine, for the virus. We've heard from Marvel. They're offering discounts to retailers. We've heard from most of the other bigger publishers, IDW, Image, Dynamite's taking some steps, so we'll see what happens there. But I don't know, I don't have a whole lot of hope. But otherwise, things here are not too bad, not too shabby. Junior Office Cat is no longer with us. We ended up having to put Lily down couple of weeks ago. She had kidney failure and cancer all kind of showed up at once, and it was a surprise because she was only 7, so that was tough. But we still got the other 3, and they're more than a handful enough for us to go around, so there's that. What else? I may end up having to cut. I may cut when this thing is done and processed. I may cut out the beginning of it to get the noise away and cut it out, so it's a halfway decent show. Maybe we'll see. I don't know. All right, 11:30. I went through all that I had to go through twice. So I think I'm going to wrap up. Tomorrow we've got a new H2O. Tomorrow also is our 11th anniversary. It kind of sneaked up on me, but tomorrow, March 23rd, it is 11 years since I started all this mess, and we'll be talking about some stuff. And I think this coming weekend we're going to celebrate a little bit with some things. So look for that. We'll let people know on social media what we're going to be doing, and you can see all our social media up here, and there's a lot of it. YouTube, Twitch, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, Minds, Gab, Library. We're also on BitChute. Some of those aren't really so much social media as just, you know, different platforms for our content. But yeah, we'll be making some announcements this week. In addition to keeping track of more Comic-Con cancellations and schedule changes and stuff, so that I'm trying to be a little bit more consistent on those and dropping those about 4 or 5 o'clock in the afternoon most days. So there's that. Plus, you know, we had a big list on Good Morning Multiverse yesterday, so you can check that out. And then, of course, we've got, if you're into comic books, if you're worried about the industry, we had an hour and a half today talking with comic book shop owners and creators about the state of things. And comics industry has been not healthy for a while, and this is not going to help. So hopefully they recover, but we'll see. All right, that will do it here. Let's see, I'm going to push that button there. That's going to do it for here tonight. Thanks for everybody being in the chat, and Sonia, thanks for pointing out that my microphone was giving off a bunch of noise, and I'll have to trim that out of the video when it goes in after it processes. So, all right, H2O tomorrow night. We've got Salacious Crumbs might be pushed back to Tuesday. So there's that. All right. Yep. I think that's it. Thanks. Bye.
You're watching Sci-Fi for Me TV.